you know, passion's a big part of anything, but a lot of people, you know, I don't know who said it, live lives of quiet desperation, right? You always say, I wish I would have done this, I wish I could do this, or whatever. My thing is, just do it. You know, my wife was a great encourager. I looked at this airplane, and I'm sitting there thinking, this is the dumbest thing I could do, is buy an airplane to do air shows that I know nothing about in my 50s. And her answer was, you've been talking about this for 20 years, just go for it. And so we did, and here we are. So, you know, the bottom line is dreams do come true, but dreams sometimes take a long time to come true. I wanted to get involved in the air show business. I was around the air show business, but it took me until I was in my 50s before I was in a position, both financially and time-wise, to do it. So all I can say is, if it's your passion, pursue it and find a way. You know, if the front door's closed, try the back door, try a window, but find a way to get involved in whatever it is you're passionate about. And if you're blessed enough to turn that into an opportunity to make some money, then even more the better, because then no day is a day of work.
Boss, Minijet engine started, taxi.
Minijet, taxi to 36.
Minijet.
That's a chance to be a rock star for a few minutes, you know? You put on the cape, as I call it, the suit. Kids think you're larger than life. In reality, I'm just another guy that's a kid that never grew up. But it's a chance to sit there and do autographs, high five, do hero shots, and hopefully maybe impact some of their lives. And you know, the flying is 10 minutes. The weekend is 3 days. So I think even more so the impact I can have on the kids is when I'm done flying is going down the line and just interacting with them and doing pictures and high fives and knuckles or whatever it is that they would want to do. Air shows, what do they mean to me? It's a way of giving back. You know, I've been blessed. I've been flying 40 years now. I got my private pilot's license since I was 19, so you can do the math. And we used to take our kids' air shows, and some of the big names that were here this weekend are on the walls of my kids' houses as far as signatures, posters. They impacted my kids, so I try and give back and impact other people's kids, motivate the next generation to, you know, either be involved in aviation, do something worthwhile with their life, maybe stay in school, maybe join the military, whatever it is, try and motivate that next generation to do something great. Because I have a job to do, you know, so I take off and I hack the clock as soon as I put gear in the well and start the music, and everything's choreographed to that clock. So I'm actually pretty busy up there, but it's just a sense of freedom. You know, I have 10 minutes to entertain kids and do what I do best, and that is to fly back and forth and do some maneuvers in a very unique aircraft and motivate the crowd. I think the biggest joy is when I get out of the jet, though, and I can interact with the kids one-on-one. And that's when I get feedback from the crowd and interaction with the crowd, and that's what I really do. Well, aviation to me is my life now. I mean, obviously I've been involved in it for a very long period of time. I hope to be involved in it until I no longer have the ability to. So it's been a passion, but it's not just one thing in aviation. The cool thing about aviation is You know, you can fly in the airlines, which I've done. You can fly a lot of different civilian airplanes, aerobatic airplanes. You can fly in the military, you can fly air shows. There's, in that arena, there's so many ways that you can challenge yourself that it's a never-ending pursuit of just doing fun things and constantly challenging yourself as an individual, as a pilot, and stretching your limits. So I just love it. Hopefully I can do it for a long time more. Oh, the dance. So you'll see us do things like this and think through, but in reality, you'll see gymnastics people do it. We used to teach it in the Air Force. We call it just doing training in your thinking what you're going to do in your performance while you're in your seat and visualizing everything you're going to do. So you'll see divers do it. You'll see gymnasts do it, and we do the same thing. We mentally go through the routine over and over. And then I like to watch the previous performer, look at their smoke trails and see what the wind is doing with them so I can anticipate what the wind is going to do to affect me and my performance. But I like to tuck into my little cubby about 30 minutes prior and get my head straight and just focus on what it is I'm going to do. And then once you take off, it's kind of all business for 10 minutes. And after that, it's all smiles for hours. My dad did flying on the side. He was an IBMer by day and did flying on the weekends as an instructor. My older brother got involved in it with U-Control and radio control. And I would get dizzy with U-Control, so I wasn't good at that. I did some radio control, but every time I flew in the back of an airplane, I got sick. I didn't even go on a roller coaster until I was 15. So I was a big wimp growing up. And then I realized by going on roller coasters later in life that you can overcome your fears, whatever you're afraid of, you just take it head on. And then I went parachuting and got over that. And then I said, well, I'm gonna take a flying lesson. And I took a flying lesson and I realized that's the first time I got in an airplane, didn't feel sick because I was busy flying. And from there on, I had my pilot's license 61 days later.
Watching my dad become an airshow pilot and being an airshow pilot, it's really cool. He's definitely achieving a dream he's had since, I was a kid going to air shows, and he'd be like, oh, there's Michael Goulian, Kirby Chambliss, Patty Wagstaff, go get their signature. And seeing them, they were my celebrities, and your dad being one makes you realize they're just normal people, but they're still really cool people. It's incredible to watch somebody achieve their dreams. So it's been a blessing to watch him become, you know, a celebrity, an air show pilot. I'd say my first like memories were waking up super early on a Sunday morning and driving, you know, an hour from our house out to the hangar, getting the plane all ready right before the sun was about to rise, and flying to breakfast with my dad and going to get pancakes up at the airport. And it's just like a free feeling, and it was really great to just, it was something I got to share with my dad, and I love it.
Oh, to hell with family, man. Family, just push family aside. Who cares about family, man? It's all about me. So, hey guys. No, my family knows, and my wife knows. Two things was, I said, hey, I'll do this, but I'll only do it if you're with me. And if you ever get tired of it, if you ever want me to pull back, if you want to do something different, then we're done. We had fun, but first priority is always family. And if my wife said tomorrow, hey, I'm tired of this, I don't want to do it anymore, then we do something else, but we do it together. But the fact that she travels with me, I got to do my first air show in front of my dad. My kids come to the air shows. My daughter and her husband came down last night at 2 in the morning just to watch us do this air show. It's just a blessing. And without that, it's just another hobby. So I'm very blessed that I can do the things I want to do and family's involved. And if they wanted me to stop tomorrow, we'd do something different. But they don't, so I get to keep doing this. It's a lot of fun. Ah, this week at Kansas City, man. Absolutely the best show in the country for us each year. I think it's the best show in the country, period. 29 acts, we were blessed to be a part of it. And just absolutely great weather, great people, and outstanding food. So it's always fun coming here. The hospitality is great, the people are great, and it was just an awesome weekend.